Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today in this video, I'm going to take you through a few important notes about resources in Oracle Primora P6. So I'll explain you that with an example in the software. So let's open the software. So if you are not on this window, just go to Enterprise and Projects. Select one of the APIs, then click on add to add a project. Some random project ID and project name. Resources, click on next. Project plan started 30 Monday morning 9 a.m. is the company start time. Select next, 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 finish. So we have the project ready. Now let us assign a calendar for this project by going to defaults, calendar, click this browse button, find avatar. So let's open the project now. Now we are on the activities window. I'll add two activities, one, two. I'll name it A and B. The duration be 5 day, 5 day each. Now the next thing is I'll assign the relationship for the B activity. I'll highlight B, I'll go to relationship, then I'll go to predecessor where I assign A as the previous activity. Now let us schedule. So you can understand after the completion of A only, the B activity will start. Now let us create a resource. Go to enterprise, I'll go to resource. If you are not able to see anything, just click on display, then go to filter by, click on all resources. So that you will see the list. Now let us add a new resource. I'll place my cursor over here, then I'll click on add. Newly created resources here, but we'll rename it. ENG4 engineer, here full form. Yeah, it is a labor. Now highlight the resource, then go to the details. Then select the calendar. For the project, since we selected 5 day 8R, for the resource also you have to go with 5 day 8R. See, when you select 5 day 8R, when you come to units and prices, the maximum units per time means per day how many hours this engineer is available. Since the calendar is 8R per day, it has automatically come 8 hours per day. Understood? So suppose the project calendar was 5-9R, even the calendar we will be choosing 5-9R, right? So if we go with 5-9R, see the changes here. See, it automatically comes 9 hours per day because for the project we are using 5-9R calendar, and for the resource we have assigned 5-9R calendar. That's why it comes automatically here. So now I'll go back to details. I'll change the calendar to 5-8R. So this is 8R now. Now we'll assign a price. I'll go with 100 per day. Got it. So now imagine that we have two engineers. See, this one means we have only one engineer now per day. Suppose if we had two engineers or three engineers, how we will create it? See, you're not going to add one more resource and going to name ENG2 This is wrong, okay? You're not going to add in this fashion. Just delete it. Just highlight the engineer that we created first. Now go to maximum per time. If we have 2 engineers per day, means you need to change this to 16. 8 into 2, 16. Then enter. This means we have 2 engineers available per day. In the same way, if we have 3 engineers, you need to enter 24 hours per day. Just enter the value 32. It will automatically take hours per day. This means we have 4 engineers. So in this case, I'm going with 8 because we have only 1 engineer. Just imagine if the calendar was 5 and 9 hour, then you need to multiply this with the same way. So 2 engineers means 18 it will be, 3 means 27, 4 engineers 36. Got it. Maximum availability. This is what the maximum availability, how many engineers we have. Not only engineer, any labor, how many we have per day. So in this case, I'm going to go with 5 day 8 hour. We'll come back to the instant prices. I'll go with the 16, which means we have 2 engineers. So, and one more thing, if you don't like such big numbers like 16, 24, 32, it's a bit confusing, right? When you just imagine if you have like 50 numbers of labors, it's going to be big numbers. So to get rid of that, you have an idea. So let that be like 40. Means 5 engineers we have. 8 into 5 will be 40. So you don't want to see this kind of big numbers. I wish that it was some small number, like exactly how many we have per day, like 1 engineers, 2 engineers, 3 engineers, like that. So for that we have an idea in this Primavera. So how do we get that? Let's go to edit, then go to user preference, then under the time units, if you go to units format, you can just change it to day, then uncheck this show unit label. Now what happens is that, problem solved. We had 5 engineers, you can see properly 5 here, so nothing confusing. You now know how much. So if you want to have 2 engineers, just enter 2. 3 means 3. So still if you are wondering, is this right? Let me just go to edit, user preference, I'll change this to R. Show it label, see it became 24 automatically. So I hope you understood the relation between this maximum per time and this user preference. So I'll change it to 8 now. I'll go to edit, user preference, I'll keep it in day. So you can see 1. We have 1 engineer. Got it right? 1 engineer we have. Now let's go to, yeah, let it be in the day format, 1 per day. So I'll make it 3 per day. Just imagine. We have 3 engineers. Got it right? 3 engineers we have. If I change the format to R, you can say 24. I'll go back to user preference, day, we have 3. So from the 3 resource, let us assign the resource to the activities. So I'll go to the activities window. For the first activity, I'm going to assign 1 from the 3 resources, like 3 numbers. Then again for the B activity, I'm going to assign 2 from the 3 engineers. So let's see how do we do that. So I'll go to A activity, then I'll go to resource. Now do one thing, click on add resource, add engineer. For the B activity also, let us assign engineer. So by default when you assign resource to an activity, it takes one resource by default. So here you can see many details. Just right click on that, customize. We don't want all these things. Let's remove them. Let us add only the things that we want. So we want budgeted units per time and budgeted units. This one, these two we want. I'll tell you what are they. Now apply. Okay. So this means, see, this is where you assign how many resources needed for a particular activity. For the A activity, I want only one out of three. I told you in resource we have three engineers, not just one, three we have. Per day we have three engineers available. From three, I wanted only one. So in that case, you are going to enter it here, one. So per day one, for the 5 days, it will be 5. Again, if you go to B activity, see by default you can see it takes only one, but you can assign maximum of 3 because we have maximum availability 3. So let's go with 2. Out of 3, I'm choosing 2. I want 2 engineers per day for this B activity. So per day 2 for 5 days, it will be 10. So I'll just change the user preference here into R. So you can see, right, for the A activity, I want 8 hours of work from engineers. For 5 days, it will be 40. For the B activity, I'm going to consume 16 hours of work per day by 2 engineers. So 16 into 5 will be 60. So let's change this to 2 numbers. So this is how you assign if you have more number of same resource. In this case, I had 3 engineers. This is mainly where you make the software understand that how many resource we have of a particular type. So in the budgeted completion, you can see for the activity, I used only one engineer out of 3 engineers. So per day, the cost was 100. So for one engineer, for 5 days, it will be 500. For the B activity, we used 2 engineers out of 3 engineers. So 2 engineers per day into 5 will be 1000. 500 plus 1000 will be 1500. So this is the planned total cost of these two activities. So I hope you understood about this video. If you have any doubts, you can comment below. And if you want to get more updates on my YouTube channel, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.